Patriotic songs have echoed today off the old train cars, which became part of the memorial exhibit. Here, visitors can learn about the battle that took place 101 years ago. Among those honoring the memory of the heroes of Kruty were the students of the Chernihiv Military Lyceum.
Young guys just like us were not afraid to stand against a large army that outnumbered our forces and managed to withstand the attack, which allowed us to sign the treaty and to save the independence of Ukraine. The guys were not afraid to put their lives on the line for the independence of our country.
Workers of the memorial complex are dressed in World War I era military uniforms worn by the troops of the Ukrainian People's Republic.
The badge on my cap is a symbol of unity. Ukrainians just attached them to caps when there were no cockades. The other option was the badge with Archangel Michael. It was shaped like a square, and if they didn't have it either, you could just attach ribbons in national colors, like the ones my comrade has.
Even the local residents knew very little about the historic battle. Those who did know were afraid to speak. For decades, Soviet authorities tried to conceal information about the Battle of Kruty.
This historic event was concealed at the time. No concrete data or facts were available that would support it. We were told that the battle took place, but nothing about the reasons for it, what prompted it, and who was behind it. We knew nothing at the time.
The Russian propaganda continues its attempts to belittle the historic importance of the battle near Kruty.
I think it's very wrong that until recently people talked about the Battle of Kruty as if it was a tragedy or even a defeat. In fact, we cannot say that it was a defeat. In this battle, the ratio of losses between the Ukrainian side and the Bolsheviks was 1-3 in favor of the Ukrainians, while the ratio of forces was 1-10 in favor of the Bolsheviks.
The sounds of the Ukrainian national anthem, people laid flowers at the memorial and paid their respects to the heroes of Kruty, as well as those who continue fighting for independent Ukraine over a century later. Evgenia Burda, UATV.
A campaign in honor of Ukrainians who died in the Battle of Kruty has been held in Lviv. Activists and students recited poems, sang the Ukrainian anthem and folk songs. It's featured in a new movie called Kruty 1918, which will be released on February 7th.
They were students who went to battle first. We wanted everyone at this train station, no matter where they come from, to stop and remember the events which happened in Kruty 101 years ago.
We wanted to draw the attention of passengers and just people who aren't indifferent to show them that the feet of those young people can still be felt now. It might be because of them that we have our country and we are fighting for it.